Hi, my name is Rebecca, and I'm here today with physiotherapist Julia and patient Maurice. I'm at Providence Healthcare's Toyota Motor Skills Clinic. Today we'll be talking about the basics and the importance of doing a safe and effective car transfer. Getting in and out of a car might seem like a really simple task to do. However, it involves a complex set of muscles and balance and maneuvering into a small space. The first thing somebody does when they leave the hospital is get into a car to go home. Being able to take this first step safely and effectively is important so that people can regain their independence and have a good quality of life. Julia, can you tell us a little bit more about why safe car transfers are an important part of somebody's rehabilitation?
Sure, absolutely. When somebody goes home, one of the first things they're going to have to do is to be able to get in and out of the car. And so oftentimes people are very worried about this. They may be weak, they may have had an amputation, or they may have had a stroke, and they're nervous about taking that first step to get into the car. So the car transfer clinic allows us to practice, not only with the person getting in and out of the car, but the caregiver who's going to provide the assistance as well. And we like to show them how to do it in a safe way so that everybody is safe and no injuries occur.
Great.
Maurice, why is this an important part of your rehabilitation here at Providence?
I find it very important because it taught me how to get in and out of a car. When I go home, I'll have to get in and out of a car to go and do my grocery shopping. So I find it very important to learn that here. There are some devices you can use. One is a board, which goes from the seat, car seat, to your wheelchair seat that you can slide your butt along if you can't balance properly. There's also a cushion that you can put on the car seat, which raises the height of it if it's too low for your between your chair and the car seat. And there's this other little device here. It's like a handle that fits onto the car lock part of your car door, and you can hang on to this to give you more grip.
Thanks. Julia, can you tell us a bit about the risks associated with doing an improper car transfer?
Sure. The first risk is to the person actually performing the car transfer themselves. There's always a risk of falling, and so that's why we want to show them the proper technique and ways to minimize that risk. The second risk is to the person actually assisting with the car transfer. Not using proper body mechanics may lead to an injury, a back strain, a muscle pull, and so again we want to show them the proper way to help the person transfer. It's important for them to remember that although they are assisting, they shouldn't be doing all the work. It's the person transferring that should be doing most of the work. They're just there to assist.
Thank you for joining us for part one. Be sure to watch part two when we will give you a practical demonstration and a how-to on doing a safe and effective car transfer. If you'd like more information on this subject, look in your local Yellow Pages for the Community Care Access Center or CCAC, and they'll link you with an occupational therapist or a physiotherapist in your community.